Crackles, also known as rales, are rattling abnormal lung sounds that can be heard when collapsed alveoli or smaller airways pop open during inspiration. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Auscultation is the process of using a stethoscope to listen to the sounds within the lungs. When crackles are heard during auscultation, they are typically associated with the presence of fluid or secretions in the airway. Crackles can occur during both inspiration and expiration, but are more common during the inspiratory phase of breathing. There are two primary types of crackles that you should know: fine crackles and coarse crackles. Fine crackles indicate that fluid is in the smaller airways. They have a high frequency and a shorter duration. These are often heard in patients with congestive heart failure and pulmonary edema. They can be treated with diuretic medications such as Lasix. Coarse crackles, on the other hand, are lower in pitch and longer in duration. They are caused by secretions in the larger airways. This type is often referred to as ronchi, which is an abnormal breath sound that can be heard when air moves through the larger airways that have accumulated mucus or secretions. Coarse crackles are typically heard during the expiratory phase of breathing. They can be treated with airway suctioning or bronchial hygiene therapy. Some other types of crackles include bilateral crackles, which are sounds that are heard in both lungs, basal crackles, which are sounds that are heard in the base of the lung, or bibasal crackles, which are basal crackles that can be heard in both lungs. There are several different conditions that can cause crackles, including pulmonary edema, CHF, pneumonia, atelectasis, pulmonary fibrosis, acute bronchitis, bronchiectasis, ARDS, and interstitial lung disease. One important tidbit to remember is that crackles that do not clear after a patient coughs are usually associated with pulmonary edema or fluid in the alveoli due to CHF. If you want to support the channel, be sure to like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.